coating and crumb coating a chocolate espresso cake, and I am filling it with peanut butter mousse. This is almond cake with a salted caramel cream cheese. The little green specks on the cake that I am getting rid of are green sprinkles. It helps me to keep track of which cake tier is which flavor when I'm doing multiple flavors. I undercooked my tiers here, so I am just digging out a little bit of the center and replacing it with some of the cake top. Rolling out some fondant to place on top of my cake board. I just add a little bit of water to help the fondant stick. Now it's time to dowel and stack the tiers, so I just have my parchment circles and my dowel rods, and I am cutting them to size. I dowel each tier so that it can support the weight of the tier on top of it, and then at the very end I drive two long dowel rods all the way from the top of the cake into the cake board so that when I drive it's not going to shift on me. And I do all this at the bakery because you have less control over the temperature of your cake at the venue. I am making the two dogs for the bottom of the cake. The bride and groom couldn't have their dogs at the ceremony, so they wanted to bring them in somehow, and this is how we decided to do it, which I think is super cute. So they're going to be at the very bottom of the cake, peeking out under the fondant curtain. Right here, I've piped some buttercream on all four tiers, and then I am taking my fondant draping and draping it down the cake and just kind of making it kind of flow down and getting exactly where I want it. Trinkets with chocolate because the chocolate hardens really hard, better than icing. This is the final product set up at the venue, the Springs in Alvarado, here in Texas.